गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एजियोट्रॉप्स। एजियोट्रॉप्स आर द बाइनरी मिक्सचर हैविंग द सेम कंपोजिशन आइदर इन लिक्विड एज वेल एज वेपर स्टेट। बाइनरी मिक्सचर जिसका कंपोजिशन लिक्विड और वेपर स्टेट में सेम रहे एंड दे बॉइल एट द सेम टेम्परेचर इज नोन एज एजियोट्रॉप्स।
इट इज binary mixture having same composition in liquid as well as vapor state.
They boil at the same temperature.
Yeah, they boil at constant temperature. So it is very difficult to separate them out by a mere boiling.
Further, it is classified in two categories. First is minimum boiling azeotropes.
Minimum boiling azeotropes.
The minimum boiling azeotropes is a binary mixture whose boiling point is less than their individual components. Since it is a binary mixture, hence it is made up by the two components. One is the solute and second one is the solvent. If the boiling point of the solution is less than boiling point of the solvent or solute, then this type of binary mixture is known as minimum boiling azeotropes.
Whose boiling point BP is less than its individual component.
Generally, those solutions which are showing large positive deviation from the Raoult law are minimum boiling azeotropes.
Large positive deviation.
Forms minimum boiling azeotropes.
वो solution जो Raoult law से large positive deviation show करते हैं वो solution forms minimum boiling azeotropes.
Simply, a solution in which whose boiling point is less than its individual component, then it is a minimum boiling azeotropes. Generally, वो solution जो Raoult law से large positive deviation show करते हैं, वो ऐसा minimum boiling azeotropes solution बनाते हैं. Okay, example. The nearly 95% ethanol. Plus 5% water. Specific composition ही solution का azeotropes बनाएगा. हर concentration पे या हर composition पे ethanol और water का solution minimum boiling azeotropes नहीं होगा. कुछ book वाले इसको 94.5 plus 4.5 water लेते हैं. It's not a matter of discussion. Nearly 95% plus 5% water is known as minimum boiling azeotropes. Then, now we will go for maximum boiling azeotropes.
It's a just inverse of this. In minimum boiling adiabatic to be defined as are the binary mixture in which boiling point of the solution is less than its indivisible component. If it is more than its indivisible component, then it is a maximum boiling adiabatic. And generally, those solutions which are showing a large negative deviation from the Raoult law are forms maximum boiling adiabatic. Maximum, second one, maximum boiling adiabatic. Binary mixture, since the adiabatic is a binary mixture, in which boiling point Vp of solution is greater than its indivisible component. These type of maximum boiling adiabatics are formed by the those solution which are showing a large negative deviation from the Raoult law. Those solution which showing shows large negative deviation from Raoult law forms maximum boiling adiabatics. Maximum boiling adiabatics. Common example, 68% nitric acid and 32% water. 68% HNO3 and 32% water. Once again, I am repeating here, only solution at the specific composition forms are adiabatics. At every composition, the solution of nitric acid and water will not form maximum boiling adiabatics. It's all about adiabatics. Now our next topic is colligative property. Colligative property is what? Colligative property is the property of solution which depend upon number of solute particles, not on the nature. Particles may be atom, ion or molecules. There are the four colligative properties. First one is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. Second one is the elevation of boiling point. And third one is the depression in freezing point. And fourth one is the osmotic pressure. So we will take it one by one. Our heading or our topic is the colligative property. Colligative property is the most important topic in this chapter. Generally, it gives one numerical in final exam of the 3 marks along with multiple choice question. So, you have understand it properly. It will be very useful. Colligative property. Property of a solution which depend upon number of solute particles, not on the nature. Properties of solution which depend upon number of solute particles, of these particles may be atom, may ions, may molecules. Not upon the nature. So there are the four colligative properties which we have to study in this chapter. First one is the relative lowering in vapor pressure. I am writing here Vp, vapor pressure. Second one is the elevation of boiling point. Boiling point Vp. Third one is the depression of freezing point. And last one is the osmotic pressure. Fourth one, osmotic pressure. We will discuss one by one. First, relative lowering in vapor pressure. Since we know colligative property are the property of solution which depend upon the number of solute particle, particles may be atom, ion or molecules. It do not depend upon the nature of particles. So how it is, it will be explained. I am taking first relative lowering in vapor pressure. Prepare a solution by adding a non-volatile solute into the solvent. Non-volatile solute occupy a certain space at the surface of solution and reduce the rate of vaporization. Hence, less amount of vapor is formed and vapor pressure get reduced. This lowering in vapor pressure in respect to the initial vapor pressure of the solvent is known as relative lowering in vapor pressure. Once again, I am repeating, I am not writing over here. You just show the video and write the theory. When we add non-volatile solute into the solvent to prepare a solution, non-volatile solute occupies certain space at the surface of solution and reduce the rate of vaporization. And less amount of vapor is formed and vapor pressure of the solution get reduced. That lowering in vapor pressure in respect to initial vapor pressure of pure solvent is known as relative lowering in vapor pressure. First you have to write these lines. Then let's suppose PA0 Vp of pure solvent, PS Vp of solution after adding non-volatile solute. Then lowering in vapor pressure PA0 minus PS. In respect to initial, it is PA0. It is relative lowering. According to Raoult's law, relative lowering in vapor pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of non-volatile solute. As you know, xB is the mole fraction, then xB is equal to nB upon nA plus nB. Right? Ratio of the mole of a particular component to the total number of the mole of a solution. The xB is equal to NaB upon Na plus NB. Okay. Now, Na is very, very greater than NB. As we all know that the composition in a solution, the number of solute particle is very, very less than number of solvent particle, and Na is the number of solvent particle. Hence, PA0 minus PS upon PA0, that means relative lowering, can be written as NB upon N. NB number of mole of solute, which is equal to WB by MB, and NA is WA by MA. If we solve mathematically, it will be WB into MA upon MB into WA. Hence, by using this, we can find out the molecular mass of non-volatile solute which is added into the solvent to prepare a solution, and which is equal to mb is equal to, by exchanging this, pa0 upon pa0 minus ps, because it will goes to the denominator, and when it will comes at the numerator, it will get revert into WB into MA upon WB. Elevation in boiling point, it is our second colligative property. Before starting the elevation in boiling point, I would like to explain boiling point. As you all know, boiling point is the temperature at which vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. Temperature at which Vp becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. The theory which is to be written under the heading of elevation of boiling point, I am explaining here. You just write it by video only. I am not going to write over here because the certain limitation is there. How the boiling point increased? As we know, when we add a non-volatile solute into the solvent to prepare a solution, non-volatile solute reduce the vapor pressure of a solution, as we explained in relative lowering in vapor pressure. So we have to supply extra heat or in form of to increase the temperature and increase the vapor pressure. So vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. That is, extra heat will increase the boiling point of a solution. And this increasing boiling point is known as elevation in boiling point. Simply, when we add a non-volatile solute in a solvent to prepare a solution, vapor pressure of the solution get reduced. So we have to supply extra heat to increase the vapor pressure, so it becomes equal to atmospheric pressure, where the solution get start boil. Hence, this increase in boiling point is known as elevation in boiling point. That can be explained by using this curve. Here we taking temperature and here is taking Vp. Vp in atm, atmospheric pressure, and temperature in Kelvin, degree Kelvin. It is the line of atmospheric pressure. When vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric vapor, liquid start boiling. We know the vapor pressure of solvent is slightly higher than solution. It is the vapor pressure of solvent. It is the vapor pressure of solution. The vapor pressure of solvent touches the atmospheric pressure at this stage, whereas the vapor pressure of solution touches the atmospheric pressure at this stage. It is the TB0, vapor pressure of pure solvent, sorry, boiling point of the pure solvent, because solvent touches the atmospheric pressure at this stage, whereas this is the vapor boiling point of the solution. It is the increase, and that is known as elevation of boiling point. It is represented by delta T B. Delta T B is what? Delta T B is elevation in boiling point. Which is equal to TB0 minus TB. Once again, I am telling you, the vapor pressure of the pure solvent is greater than vapor pressure of the solution. So to start liquid boil, we have to supply extra heat to solution. So vapor pressure gets increased and becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. That extra heat raises the boiling point of the solution, and that raise in boiling point of the solution is known as elevation in boiling point. It is observed that elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to the molar concentration of non-volatile solute.
What is the molar concentration?
Elevation in boiling point is delta B, is directly proportional to the molar concentration of the non-volatile solute. M is molar concentration of non-volatile solute. When we remove the sign of proportionality, we have to put a constant, that is the Kb, and Kb is equal to M. Kb is known as molar elevation constant. Or it is known as ebullioscopic constant. On further solving this, we can explain ebullioscopic constant or the molar elevation constant by taking M is equal to 1 unit. 1 unit means 1 mole per kg of solvent. That means molar elevation constant or the ebullioscopic constant is elevation of boiling point when 1 mole of non-volatile solute, 1 mole of non-volatile solute added 1 kg of solvent. Molar elevation constant is the elevation of boiling point when 1 mole of the non-volatile solute added in a 1 kg of solvent. Hence, del Tb is equal to Kb. If we solve this, del Tb is equal to Kbm. M is the molality. You know, molality is the number of mole of solute per 1000 gram of the solvent. By using this, we can find out the molar mass of the solute, non-volatile solute. Delta Tb will be given, Wb, gram weight of the non-volatile solute will be given, Wa, the gram weight of the solvent will be given. Hence, Mb is equal to Kb, Wb into 1000, upon Mb is Wb upon 1000 upon del Tb into Wa. It's all about elevation in boiling point. Further two corrugative property we will discuss in later on in next video. Thank you and have a nice day.